What is up, awesome people? And welcome back to my Pokemon Omega Ruby and Alpha Sapphire walkthrough. So in the last episode, we caught ourselves a Regigigas, with a critical catch too, which is freaking awesome, I will admit. So I was a little bit indecisive what I was going to do at the end of the last episode for this episode, but I've decided I'm going to go ahead and do the Elite Four. I haven't actually gone around and checked if there was a few legendaries I could catch. I know I went to see the fairy, but nothing popped up, so I'm like, oh well, bugger this, I'm heading off to Elite Four. I need to do this Elite Four anyways, because there is something we get at the end from Steven for doing it for the second time, and we also get something as well afterwards, once the credits have rolled and all that for the second time as well. After that, you don't really get anything. The Elite Four is actually a great place, finally, for doing experiences. There is no substitute for the restaurants like they'd had in Pokemon X and Y. So finally, Game Freak finally turned around and gave us the Elite Four that we were actually asking for as far as rematches go. They do get a hell of a lot stronger when you go up against Elite Four for the second time. They use different Pokemon. They do Mega Evolve, so do watch out for that. As I said, hell of a lot harder. Even Pin Knight himself, when he went through the second time, actually had a lot of trouble going through. So I've actually had to transfer a Pokemon from my Pokemon X and Y version just to do this, because I go up in the 70s and near the 80s, low 70s to high 70s, as I said, near the 80s for their levels, which is damn quite high. So none of my Pokemon are actually around that level. So a transferred Pokemon was definitely necessary. So I've actually brought over a good old friend of mine from my competitive Wi-Fi battle team. I haven't actually used my good old friend for quite some time, so it's nice to actually bring him back. Plus, I do want to do an episode on his particular species as well. So the Pokemon I have brought over for me is Furfuru, number 676. So this is I do believe, max health, most likely max speed, knowing me. It's got Frustration, Retaliate, U-Turn, and Facade. So I do believe the Elite Four will turn around and try and Willis me, especially in the second part. I don't really actually looking at that, so I've got nothing to hit Ghost-type Pokemon. Awesome! Three Normal-type moves and one Bug-type move. Awesome. Well, I won't be using Furfurup against the second one, which is Phoebe, which is a Ghost-type trainer. I didn't actually think about that when I transferred my Pokemon. But I do have Venomoth on the side, and I don't think Venomoth will be able to hit them as hard as I'd like, but we'll see how far I go with two level 100s, but I should do pretty alright with them, I suppose. I do have Martina level 67, that should be alright, especially up against Phoebe, unless she's got some freaking bulky Pokemon. I know her Sableye will be a big problem for me, because that does Mega Evolve. It does get a defense boost, from what I remember from Mega Evolution stats. Otherwise, I have Skeptile level 60, Absol level 56, and my Pelipper level 58. So these are what you call my toughest in-game Pokemon, but I did have to transfer two level 100s over just to make this a little bit easier. Otherwise, I'm going to get absolutely annihilated. Alright, so I've already healed my Pokemon and did it off-screen. The only thing I didn't do off-screen was probably buy some stuff. I have 20 full restores, I have 12 revives. What about full heals? Do I have any? I have two full heals. I might just buy another 8 of those. And probably just for the sake of it, I might buy max and max potions, because I don't want to use my full restores when I don't need to. Alright, so hopefully that's going to do me. Who's my lead? Furfuru. Venomoth will probably be the greatest lead up against Sydney. Sydney's not going to stand an absolute chance against Venomoth, especially if you've got a Sleep Powder, Quivenance combo. We'll probably just do that. I may have to use... Actually, I don't want to use Venomoth for the first one. I might use Furfuru for the first up. I haven't got an item on these either, so that's going to be very interesting to say the least. Alright, let's do this, Sydney. Let's see who the true Dark Master is. Alright, so he's been waiting for me. And as I said, these guys all freaking Mega Evolve, so Sydney's gonna have a Mega Absol in his team, and I do believe his rest of his team's... Oh man, he's got a Scrafty. Well, that's just another Oh no, what was I thinking? Scrafty, that's gonna be so annoying. Oh man. Well, that's a perfect counter straight off the bat. And he's gonna intimidate us to... That's a cherry on top. Level 70 as well, so I am going straight for the U-turn. I am getting out of there. There is not much my Furfru can really do to that thing. It'll get one-shotted most likely. That does carry high jump kick. Will most likely have bulk up, but that's just me thinking competitively there. So I got in my Venomoth, and it's got Brick Break. Well, my Furfru would not have liked that one. Even though it does have Fur Coat to halve physical moves, I still don't think it would have liked it. Alright, let's go for the Sleep Powder and start setting up Equivenants. Yeah, probably at level 100 and super effective to Dark. I think I'm going to need one of them. Alright, Equivenants. Alright, Dance Venomoth, dance! Let's get this going. Alright, still fast asleep, which is awesome. Alright, I hope you're ready for a Bug Buzz. And it's down. Alright, that's one Pokemon down. Alright, and Mudina grows level 68. That's awesome. I'm going to need all the experience I can get on my Mudina. Alright, up next is Mandibuzz, level 70. Dark Flying. Now let's see what ability this thing has. Well, we're not going to find out because it's dead. Alright, nobody leveled up. Next is Abzan. This is going to be his Mega Evolution. Alright, so when Abzan evolves, it gains the ability Magic Bounce. And it's not Mega Evolving. Well, that's interesting. I thought that Mega Oh, it was a Zoroark. Interesting. I was going to say, that was very weird. It didn't Mega Evolve. That nearly made me a liar. Level 59 for Pelipper. Alright, Shiftry. Alright, level 70. This thing has Fake Out and Leaf Blade. Actually, I'll throw a Sludge Bomb at you. Eat that. Hope it tastes yummy. Okay, so up next is Sharpedo. So I wonder if this is going to have Aqua Jet. No, it doesn't. Or it didn't use it. Sharpedo down. Well, we're just sweeping Sydney. Then again, Sydney's pretty easy to sweep if you got a fighting type or a bug type on you. And last but not least is his Abzol at level 72. This is his Mega Evolving Abzol. So Magic Bounce is his ability. And as far as his moves, it'll most likely have Night Slash. It'll have most likely Psycho Cut. And I couldn't tell you the other two. I do remember it having Sword Dance in the originals, but I don't know if it's going to still have it at that level. Alright, so that's that down, and my own Mabzol grows to level 57 and wants to learn Parasong. Nah, you don't learn that one. Bit of a waste on Abzol. And that's Sydney defeated. Absolutely swept. Alright, so we're on to Phoebe now. So I'm just going to switch my team up. I don't really have anything to hit it with my level 100, so we're going to have to go Mardina again. And see how my little beast fares. Hopefully quite well. He did actually really well when I went up against Elite Four the first time. He was a little tiny bit underleveled, I do believe. Though he grew a lot of levels in Elite Four. Alright, Phoebe. I just don't... The only thing I don't want is a Will-O-Wisp being thrown at me. Alright, Burnett lead. So her party is going to consist of a Mega Sableye, which is our newest Mega Evolution to the series. She did have two options there. She either had Mega Burnett or Sableye to Mega Evolve. I guess Mega Burnett would be a little bit boring. Anyway, so Intimidate there on the Burnett. And let's see if it lives this. And it's not. Oh, and by the way, my Mudian is also holding black glasses. I did pick one up during my playthrough, so that's going to increase all my Dark-type moves by a further 1.2 base power. And I don't want to switch it on Miss Magmius. Oh, interesting, Miss Magmius. You're quite quick. You're quite quick. And, am I going to outspeed this thing? Let's go Crunch. No, I didn't outspeed. It's got Thunderbolt. Okay, that's going to do quite a lot of nasty damage there to Mardina. And it's not going to like a Crunch whatsoever. And that's Miss Magmius down. Alright, Mardina almost level 69. Chandelure is her next Pokemon. So this is going to have Flash Fire. Oh, it's got Infiltrator as well. And I think it's last... No, I don't think it's that. I would assume it's going to have the Flash Fire ability. Alright, that's down. Alright, level 69 for my Mardina. Alright, Dustomar. Oh, bloody hell, this is gonna be quite annoying. It will definitely live a crunch, I know that. So how well it's gonna live it is another question. Come on, Mardina! Oh, nice job though. So it's going for the Thunder Punch, hoping for the Paralysis. That still does hell of a lot of damage to my Mardina. So she's going to go for a Full Restore there. I went for the Howl just to boost my attack up. Well, it's boosting its health back up. So my attack goes up, which is awesome. And she will most likely go for another Thunder Punch. So I'm going to preserve PP and go for the Sucker Punch. That's the same base power as Crunch, so it's definitely going to knock out that Dusknoir. I don't even think if it was a bit lower than Crunch's base power, that still would have killed thanks to that Howl. Anyway, so next Pokemon is Drifblim. I was going to say last, but Jose applies last. Alright, Drifblim. What the hell are you going to do? Let's see if Crunch kills. And it goes down. Awesome. It's got Aftermath. And it nearly kills my Mardina too. That was... damn. Alright, Pelipper level 60. Alright, last Pokemon is Sableye. So this is going to be a Mega Evolution. Stands at level 73. Whew, now is Playruff going to kill or not? Alright, so here comes the Mega Sableye. First time seeing it in action, and I don't like it. It's got Fake Out, you little rat. You sod, you killed my Mardina. Arrgh. You know what you can have then? You can have a sleep powder to the face then. It's got freaking magic bounce! I didn't know that. Alright, so my Metamorph is asleep instead, and it's got Power Gem. I didn't think it learnt that move. Well, that just backfired. Let's go for Restore and get my Venomoth back to full health. And that sleep is gone. Well, that is just 100% annoying. Alright. I learnt the hard way what ability it's got. Let's go Sludge Bomb. And dead. And it's a critical hit. Well, you're 100 times annoying. Alright, that's Phoebe down. Alright, so... keep that in mind, Sableye's got Magic Bounce. As I said, I actually did not know that, so I learnt it the hard way. Up next is... Bloody Glacier. Wrong one. Revive. Alright, let's bring Mardina back. And use a Max Potion on... not on Absol. I didn't mean to do it on Venomoth, didn't need it. Alright, we'll do it on that one, and then we'll switch up my party. Alright, let's go Furfru lead. Right, I know Furfru can do a lot of this party, except for freaking Frostlass. I will leave Mardina to that. And here we go. Alright, so her Mega... he is Mega Glalie, so... I'm trying to think of what boost it had. I can't actually remember. Alright, her lead is a Bomber Snow. Well, how suiting is that? That's going to have Snow Warning, and it's going to kick in her annoying Snow Veils. Alright, Furfru lead. And out comes the Snow Warning, so it's going to hail for 5 turns. Let's go Frustration. And it doesn't kill. Awesome! You better not like me, Furfru, because I could have swore you had no happiness. Alright, Howl's gonna hurt me there after a Blizzard. And I'll just finish it off with a Passat. For a store, really? I will have a Passat then. Well, that did a lot more than... what my Frustration did. What the hell? Oh damn. I don't get my Furfru. I could have swore I had no happiness because I've never used the damn thing. level 58 for my Absol. Hail there's gonna do some residual damage, and up next is Bear Tick. Alright, what to do against this thing? Let's go Facade. Alright, there's a lot of damage. It's got Brick Break. Well, that's not gonna do an awful lot thanks to Fur Coat. A little bit of hail damage there, and let's just finish off with a Frustration. I'm frustrated that it's not doing it at max damage. Don't tell me it's growing some type of happiness. Alright, Frostlass is next. I know exactly how to counter that one. Come out, my beast! Alright, Frostlass, level 72. Intimidate on that one, so it's not particularly matter because this thing is more of a special attacker. It'll most likely go for Hail, so let's go Crunch. No, it's going for Blizzard. And that's going to do a hell of a lot of damage. I thawed out! Woohoo! You beast! And that's Frostlass down. What a little beast! First turn Thor out. Alright, Vanillax is next. Alrighty, righty, righty. This thing is slow as sugar. And Crunch should kill. Nope, it's bulky in defense. It's got Signal Beam. What is this? And I'm dead. Almighty Yina. It doesn't deserve that. Right, out comes Furfury. And let's go for Retaliate. Usually this is my Bandit set, but I don't have Choice Bands, so this is going to have to make do. Alright, Skeptile level 62. And Warreen. Alright, this will most likely go for She Cold. Just to be a little pain in the rear side. Nice work, Furfury. No, it's got Blizzard. Down to the red for me. Another Facade coming its way, and that's Warreen down. Alright, Glalie, this is most likely her Mega Evolution. Alright, let's send out Venomoth for this one. Furfury's a little bit wear for tear there. Alright, Glalie, level 74. This will be her Mega Evolution, so let's go for a Bug Buzz. Now this has Refrigerate for an ability, so all normal type moves will turn into Ice type moves, which means Stab Explosion, Stab Hyper Beam, which is not fun to go up against. And why does it have Protect? I could have gone for a Quiver Dance. Alright, let's see if this kills. Of course it is. Down it goes. Alright, Pelipper level 61. And that's Glacier defeated. Burn, baby! Alright, Drake is next. And Drake is not fun. Oops, what am I doing that for? Alright, revive my Mardina. And then let's go heal my Furfru. That's a lot of health. And Fax Potion my Mardina. I've got two left, then it's full restoring time again. I might keep my Furfru lead. Furfru is freaking awesome. Alright, what a long trek that is. Alright, we have Drake next, and I'm not actually up against him. Alright, so Mega Mince. This is not gonna be an easy battle. Alright, what type of dragon types is he carrying? He better not have a Garchomp, because I'm gonna probably pee my pants. Alright, steal that Altaria lead. So this thing will most likely have Cotton Guard. Dragon Pulse. D-Dance, maybe? It could even have Earthquake. Alright, what to do against this thing? Let's go Frustration. Right, it definitely has Cotton Guard, which means probably the next turn he may go for a Furor Store. Yep, we're in range. Alright, so my frustration is not going to do that much more damage. It's probably going to do like half of that. Oh my goodness, that was like dreadful. Let's try facade. Well, that didn't do any much better. And it's going to hit me specially, which is quite annoying. That was a crit and it did nothing. Haha. What to do? Let's go U-turn out of here. That actually did something. Alright, I'm gonna go into my Venomoth here. Alright, another D-pulse coming my way. And it's gonna do very little to my Venomoth. And let's go Sleep Powder. It actually hit, which is awesome. Been quite lucky with my Sleep Powders. Alright, it's fast asleep. And from there, we'll set up a few Quiver Dancers. Probably... I don't even know what he's got in his team, so I'm probably assume I'm going to put up two of them. That way, it'll assure me I don't get hit by anything nasty, and I will be able to outspeed everything. Well, then again, I'll be able to outspeed everything. I just want to make sure I one-shot everything. Right, finish it off with a Sludge Bomb. That's Altaria down. Right, Mudina level 70. Right, next up is Flygon. That'll definitely have Stone Edge or Rock Tomb or Rock Slide, one of the two, or one of the three. Anyway, it's not going to use it regardless, so that's down. Absol level 59. Dragledge. Well, I have absolutely nothing for this. Let's go Bug Buzz! Oh wow, it killed. Haxorus! I thought he might have one of these. Well, this would definitely have D-Dance. It's got more Breaker. We'll Sludge Bomb that, so take a Sludge Bomb to the face. If he lived, I would have been raging. Okay, next up is Kingdra. He's still got that Kingdra, he's still got Flygon, he's still got Altaria. He's just got two new Pokemon. And that's Kingdra down. Right, Skeptile level 63 and wants to learn Leaf Storm. That'd be great for Mega Skeptile. Might get rid of Mega Drain. That is pretty handy move though for when it comes to legendaries, but I don't think I'm going to need it because I got false swipes now. And last but not least is his Salamence, level 75 with Intimidate. So when it goes into Mega, I do believe it's got Aerial Ape, which will turn all normal type moves into flying type moves, which again means Stab, Hyper Beam, Giga Impact, Aerial... There's another move I was thinking of that's got Stab. Regardless, it's going to go down. It does get a defense boost, I also noticed too, which is quite interesting. So it might even lift an Ice Shard if it's a non-stab one. However, if it's coming from a pretty strong Pokemon like a Bombasnow, then it's definitely not living an Ice Shard. Alright, that's him down. Now, who the frippin' hell am I going to use up against Steven? I could use Mudina, I suppose. I have an idea. I have no idea if it's going to work, but let's try it. Alright, so let's enter the big gates of victory and see how we fare up against Steven's team. I will admit, it's... Well, it may look like it's been quite easy, but... Yeah, if you didn't go through level 100s, it might be a bit of a challenge. Alright, so he's going to test my skills yet again. Alright, so prepare for quite a hard fight if you don't have level 100s or a good counter like I do. So I'm a bit worried because I don't have a guaranteed counter this team. But he's only with his Skarmory, that's going to be like level 75 or something. Level 74? 77? What a... Oh my goodness gracious me. And I miss. Of course I flip and do. Well, out of all the times with Sleep Powder to miss, it had to be now. Alright, unless it hits the second time round, Skarmory has a Spikes on the field, which is quite annoying. I was going to try and make use of that, but it ain't going to happen now. It also has Toxic. I do believe I fell victim to that the last time I came here. While it snows on the job, I'm going to switch into my Mighty Ena and start setting up on this thing. I'm going to get Intimidate off at least, so that's going to lower its Steel Wing. Unless it's got Brave Bird, which I'm hoping it doesn't. Alright, let's go start setting up my house. My Crunch is a little low too. And it woke up. Why must you wake up? I actually still did a decent amount of damage. Then again, there is a 7 level difference between Skarmory and Mighty Ena, so I might even need a plus 6 to be able to take on this team. Ow. Right, that's my third one. It's the Toxic. Alright, so watch out if you are going to stat up on this thing. It does have Toxic. I'm going to one more turn and then probably just heal up. Number four. Oh, I knew he'd go for a Spikes. And I'm going to have to heal. I can't risk another turn. Alright, so poison is gone. Steel Wing on my way. I knew it. Hound number 5. There's the last layer of spikes. So that means the next turn he'll go for a Steel Wing. Or maybe a Toxic. I hope he goes for a Toxic. He does. So I can take sweet, sweet, sweet advantage of that. Go for a full restore next turn. And then when he goes for a Steel Wing, I can just crunch in the next turn. I will probably get outsped though. Alright, there's the Steel Wing. Alright, I still outsped. Awesome. That's Skarmory down. Oh, it's got freaking Sturdy. I forgot about that. And there's the full restore, which means another Sturdy is going to kick in. You annoying little bird. Stop with your Sturdies. And I missed with... Oh, it missed too. Awesome. Alright, there's the Play Rough and there's Skarmory down. Nice work, Mighty Ena. Alright, Pelipper, level 62. Carbink! Oh my freaking goodness! What am I going to do to this thing? I don't think Play Rough's going to kill either. Oh my goodness, it lived! At a plus 6! I'm dead. Aw, oh, bad luck, Mighty Ena. Did not expect the freaking Carbink to come onto the field. Right, Carbink. Ow. Carbink. I'll just wait for the Sludge Bomb. Alright, if I'd known that was coming up, I probably wouldn't have set up this plus 6. Now I'm in a very rough situation. Alright, I sent out my Pelipper. Even though I'm going to get absolutely devastated by Rock Slide or Stone Edge. Even the level difference showed I wasn't going to kill it. And there's the bloody Stone Edge. There goes Pelipper. Oh my goodness gracious me. Alright, out comes Absol. I wonder if I'm going to even outspeed this thing. I did outspeed. I just missed! And Absol got wrecked. I can't believe I just missed that kill. And they are definitely hurting. Ah, oh, bugger. I knew he was going to go for a full restore. I thought just in case he wasn't, I'd go for a bug buzz. That bloody sturdy. Oh, that's Aggron down. Claydol is up next. Let's smack this with a bug buzz. And that's Claydol down. What if any more Pokemon with Sturdy's gonna pop up? Aerodactyl. It's got pressure. Alright, let's go Sludge Bomb. Oh my goodness, it lived. And a Rock Slide's coming my way. I might be dead. Yep. Alright, my Venomoth goes down. Let's bring up my Skeptile. Those spikes definitely do hurt. Lucky I got a Max Revive on me. Alright, let's Max Revive my Venomoth. This thing does have Fire Fang. I am definitely down to that one. Alright, Venomoth back out again. Finishing off with Bug Buzz. And that's Aerodactyl down. Alright, last is his Metagross. Which of course is Mega. Level 79, that's a really monstrous level. Alright, so there's the Mega Evolution, and this thing gets a whole bunch of stat boost. And it's got bloody tough claws too. However, it is going to sleep, so that's a good thing. Alright, let's see how much Bug Buzz does. This should be neutral. Oh wow, that lived it like a bloody boss! Bloody hell! I have two Bug Buzz left. That's Metagross down. Whew! My goodness, even level 70's lived up to a level 100. Well, I definitely didn't transfer the most capable Pokemon, that's for sure. Alright, so after all that, we get the Metagrossite. So for those who don't get the event Pokemon, build them from your mystery gift, or you're watching this later on in the future, and you missed out on the Shiny Beldum event, this is where you get the Metagrossite. For those who did do the Shiny Beldum event, will have the Metagrossite on their Shiny Beldum, so this will be your second one. Alright, so time to head to the Hall of Fame and commemorate our second victory with my team. I think next time I'll transfer over a little bit more of a capable team for the Elite Four. Probably something that can handle Steel-type Pokemon and Ghost-type Pokemon. Then again, Mighty Ian still did an excellent job up against Phoebe. Regardless if it was so many levels lower. That stupid Cowbank, though. Anyways. My team for the second time round consists of Venomoth, level 100. My shiny Furfuru, level 100. Mardiena, the absolute beast at level 70. Skeptile, level 63. Abzol, level 59, not too far off level 60. And my Pelipper, level 62. Well done, team. You're an absolute beast of a team. Alright, so once that's all done, we need to head back to Little Root Town, so skippy's through this. You can skip the credits now, which is awesome. Anytime now. Alrighty, so there's one last thing we need to pick up for this episode, and then I'll call it quits for that one. Right, so when you start back up again, you'll be in Little Root Town. nothing interesting will happen down here, I don't think anyway. And we got this final scene with Professor Birch. So what is he being chased by now? Jeez, this man can't catch a break. Wait, what? Why is my mum chasing him? Why? First it was a shroomish, then the matrix postal delivery, and now, of all things, my mum. Really? What are you doing with my mum anyway, Professor Birch? Anyway, questions aside, because I'll never understand that, we now have the Sinnoh starters. We have Tortwig, Chimchar, and Piplup. So Tortwig will go into Torterra, Chimchar into Fernape, and Piplup into Empoleon, the water steel type. Torterra is grass ground, and Infernape is firefighting. Most people here will go for Chimchar, only because of Infernape, plus it is the stronger one. I do quite like my Infernape, I do quite like my Torterra, and I do quite like my Empoleon. It's such a hard choice here. The 4th gen starters were absolutely amazing. I couldn't fault any of these. Who to go for? Oh, why not? We'll go for Chimchar. And he's quite happy about that choice too. Alright, what were you doing with my mum? Oh my, I sure did misread this situation now, didn't I? I assumed it was a Pokemon chasing after me, but it was just my own... it was his own wife. Oh, oopsies, I thought it was my mum. Oopsie! I take back all the assumptions. But why... Oh my goodness, I'm not even gonna know what they're up to there. We'll leave that one alone. And I didn't even know what I just read then. I'm pretty sure they said we'll come play at my house, but... Oh my goodness, let's just leave that topic alone. Anyways, guys, that's it for this episode. It was a pretty long episode, sorry about that. But anyways, that's how you get the last remaining starters to pick up from Omega Ruby and Alpha Sapphire. As for the first generation starters and the sixth generation starters, you'll need to trade them from Pokemon X and Y. There is no way of picking them up in Omega Ruby and Alpha Sapphire, so they're trade exclusives only. And as for the other two starters that you do pick up from each of those events, the Johto starters after the first time being Elite Four, the Unova starters from the Delta episode that you do get, and the ones that obviously I just got then, you'll need to trade the other two remainders, either from Pokemon X and Y or from someone else who has them. So I've also covered how to get all the other starters, which is really cool, and I do like that little inclusion in the game. And I am pretty damn sure, it has not been confirmed yet, but I'm pretty sure it is true to its facts and its roots that the 5th generation starters and the 2nd gen starters still don't have their hidden abilities, which is quite annoying in some ways, but kind of okay in some ways, I suppose. I don't know. If you're an NU player like me, I suppose it's a good thing I don't have their hidden abilities. It means you can still use them in NU and the low tiers. But anyways, until I do find out those guys have their hidden abilities, I guess until now they're still unreleased, which is a bit of a bummer. So yeah. Anyways, this has been a very, very, very long episode, so I better end it off here now before I make it any longer. But thank you so much, guys, for sticking around the entire episode if you have. And if you haven't already, make sure to check out my previous episodes for Omega Ruby and Alpha Sapphire. And if you like what you see, make sure to stick around for future episodes. So, if it's not a legendary capture next, it will definitely be the How to Catch series. I have actually out of ideas on what to cover for the walkthrough. So if you guys have any ideas for me that I can cover, leave them in the comments section below and I will try my best to try and cover it if I know how to, that is. I may do a few things on secret bases, I may do something on Megastones, I don't particularly want to because I think that's been blasted by so many other people and it's not really that hard to really go look up Cerebeat either. The internet is your friend there, of course, but yeah, I'll try and cover whatever the hell I can anyway. Anyways, that's it for this episode, so until the next episode, this is Lady Crimson saying ciao for now, but not forever. Ciao!